So Newton's first law of motion was that an object at rest wants to, everyone say, stay at rest.
Stay at rest.
An object in motion wants to
stay in motion.
Stay in motion. And essentially, that is Newton's first law, and that is the concept of inertia. Let me show you with what I call an inertia hat. Now, this might look pretty funny, right? This doesn't really look like a hat. I made it out of a coat hanger and two tennis balls. And if I place the inertia hat on my head, does it have the inertia of being in motion or staying at rest?
Staying at rest.
Staying at rest. You might see just a little bit of movement because I'm talking and there's slight movements with my head moving and with the air in the classroom moving, but for the most part, this is staying still. Now watch what happens if I change the inertia by applying a force. So here's the force. Now what inertia does it have? Staying in motion or staying at rest?
Staying in motion.
And it's going around and around until the friction from the hanger hitting the top of my head slows it down. Now it's slowing down and it stops. Now I'm going to move. And did it change? Did it start moving?
No,
because there wasn't a force applied to it like when I moved it with my hand. There is friction happening, and because I'm not keeping my head perfectly still, there maybe was a little bit of a wobble. But it didn't really move, it mostly stayed still because it... I'm going to show you how to make your own inertia hat, which is great fun for seeing if you can spin around and have the hat stay still, or giving one side a little push and letting it orbit your head like a pair of planets. There we go, with a smoother push, it goes round and around like it's orbiting the sun. Lots of fun. So to make one, you just need a coat hanger and a little bit of patience because it is tricky to get it to balance like this. So the first thing you want to do is untwist your hanger so that you just have the wire. And you're going to try and get this as straight as you can. The straighter you get your hanger, the easier the next part is. So it doesn't need to be perfectly straight. I'm calling that good enough. Now we're going to bend it approximately in half, and once you get it bent in half, then you are going to take the ends and curve them down in an M shape, and you want the bottom part to be lower than your middle or your V. So we get them kind of heart-shaped, rounded. There we go with that end, and now the other end. And you can use pretty much anything to go on the end. So these tennis balls, wool dryer balls work well. I've got this one that I made with squeaky toys from the dollar store and little styrofoam eggs. These are a little bit too light. They don't work quite as well as the tennis balls, but they're a little more comfortable on the top of your head when they're lighter. So plus or minus, depending on what you use. You can see how this hat is not staying up straight. It's tipping forward. And that means that it's not in line. So I could try to adjust it by pulling something back a little bit and then just balance it on your hand and see if that looks better. And it won't take too long for you to figure out that minor tweaks make a big difference. Even it out. Whoa! And see, all of a sudden I did something wonky, and instead of the hat balancing upright now, it's balancing in that weird, crazy angle, and we don't want that because it's not going to stay on my head well if it's not balancing upright. So I need to try and tweak it back, see if that was enough. And there we go, now we're almost upright again. Oh, yes! I want to tell you something important about inertia. Mass matters when it comes to inertia. The amount of stuff that you have, the amount of weight, is going to make a really big difference. I'm going to be applying about the same amount of force each time I flick my finger. And is it a whole lot of force or not that much, right? Now, here is an empty water bottle. It's really light. Here is a half full water bottle. And here is a water bottle that's almost all the way full and is a lot heavier. Watch what happens to these water bottles when I flick them. So the light one just fell right over, right? That one tipped forward, but then went immediately right back. Ah, and that one I just hurt my finger, but it really doesn't move very much at all. And that's because this one has more
weight.
Everyone say inertia.
Inertia.
It has more inertia.
Oh!
because it is light and it doesn't have as much inertia. And so when I pulled it out, this one tipped over. Did you see any difference between how these ones behaved? This was interesting. We had, just like Goldilocks and the Three Bears, we have too light, too heavy, and just right. Now, right now, these Easter eggs, which are full of Play-Doh, so that makes them kind of heavy, and things that are heavy have more inertia. These Easter eggs, are they at rest or are they moving?
Rest.
They're at rest, so they have the inertia of wanting to stay at rest. And if I apply a force to them, they'll move. But if I don't apply a force to the egg, but instead apply a force to the pan, then I should be able to get the egg to land in the cup. You guys ready?
Oh my god.
Yeah, we'll do 1, 2, 3, go. Woo! Round of applause for the boys. They're amazing. There's another variation on this we're gonna do now with bunnies. So, and this time, I would like to have two students come up. And 1, 2, 3. Say 1, 2, 3, and it'll be like slow motion pulling back, and let's see what happens, okay? 1, 2, 3, slowly go back. Very different, right? If I give this string a tug and get them started, once part of this string of beads has inertia, it starts moving and it wants to stay in motion, it wants to keep moving, and it pulls the rest of the beads out. But if you watch closely, you'll see something really cool. When they come out, they don't just come over the top like this, they actually lift up and over the edge. You guys ready? Happens pretty fast. I'll put them in and we'll do it one more time. You can buy inertia beads online, but you don't need to. You can make your own by taking party necklaces, cutting them apart, and then fixing them together with duct tape. This is the 47th string in my homemade inertia beads, and when you put them in the container, you just need to be sure to put them in bit by bit, the same way that you want them to come out. So, let's give them a tug and see how they do. When you put them back in the container, it's important to feed them in the same way that they come out. Oh, and then just have the egg. Sure, we can try that. 3.
The bunny on the toilet paper roll?
Sure. That would be the one to do next.